man-to-man offense, but defense.
Oliver Lee at 6'7" against Orlando Woolridge, 2 inches taller for Notre Dame. And it's the Irish who get control. And up over our heads.
I thought if you'd have caught that one, Coach, you could have given a little spin on the finger.
One-year eligibility.
St. John's has been scouting you.
Branning, the Irish, is there on the attack for the first time against Wilson. And a whistle. Wilson crowding him with his shoulder, and that's the first foul.
This is what Marquette wants to stay away from, the foul situation. Their bench is very thin. They can't go by the sixth man. Michael Wilson, the kid out of Memphis State, is very quick on defense.
A reminder again that we are going to be switching periodically live to the contest at Baton Rouge, Louisiana, LSU, and Kentucky. The winner of that one to win the Southeastern Conference Championship. Don Cricky and Billy Packer with a call in the South. We'll be going there throughout the course of our telecast here from Notre Dame. Just underway.
Marquette sitting in the 2-3 zone because Notre Dame took the ball out from the baseline.
Bill Hanslake, first shot, and Notre Dame leads. By the Irish in the backcourt. Wilson brings it down against Branning. Off to Oliver Lee. Introduce the players. Worthen's the playmaking guard, number 31, one of the finest passers in the game. Wilson with a travel. Notre Dame on the turnover, leading 2-0. See both coaches, one not too happy, and the other at the far end in the raspberry jacket. Digger Phelps motioning for his team to get into the offense.
Looks like it's good humor suit. I'll take a couple of ice cream cones, please.
2-0. The Irish lead it. Jackson to Hanslick. Tripuka posting up inside, as the coach told you he would. No basket, but a foul.
Well, you got Robert Bird picking up on Tracy Jackson. That's the fellow they want to stop offensively more than Kelly Tripuka.
Foul is on Wilson, and he has two fouls already.
Well, that's the early we're going to see Artie Green. He's worth the price of admission. They call him the anti-gravity man.
Tripuka at the line, the best free throw shooter for the Irish. Been over the 80% mark most of the year. Has just slipped under it.
Since Tripuka returned to the lineup, the Irish have been hot. He scored 15, then 17, 20, 24, 29, and 20 in the 6 games since his injury.
He had a back spasm. Kept him out for about 6 games, 5 or 6 games.
He misses both free throws, but Jackson in to convert it, and he is fouled by Schlunt. You talked about the lack of rebounding by Marquette, and that's apparent already.
Yeah, they got inside position on this. Watch Carroll Schlunt just catch him on the outside here. There goes up Tracy, catches him on the outside there. Good call.
Dean Marquardt, number 45, comes in for Schlunt as Hank Raymonds makes a quick substitution, trying to fortify his rebounding attack. Jackson after the three-point play. And it's 5-0 Notre Dame.
They need this basket right here. Watch the Sergeant Sanders take it on his own.
Lee in the corner. Worthen saying, get the ball to me. Let me set up our offense. Wilson. Not there. Lee!
That's a technical.
Basket is good, but it is a technical.
Definitely technical. He grasped it with both hands that time. The ball plays out of the land guard. Here's the shot by Wilson. He comes off the rim. Now he dunks it and grabs it. See, now watch the basket shake there a moment.
Here it is again from another angle.
And there it's in there. See him grab with both hands. That's definitely a technical foul.
So Tripuka gets one shot at the other end. Score 5-2 Notre Dame. And he rattles that one home. 6-2 the Irish, and it'll be Notre Dame's ball at midcourt.
Surprisingly, even that one went in. His trajectory's too low.
Digger, less formal attire today. The coat with the open collar.
Well, he knows he has the bid. He doesn't have to wear a tie. Hank Raymonds has to wear a tie yet to get the bid.
Woolridge outside with Lee. Tripuka draws Marquardt.
Marquette, a hard man-to-man.
Jackson, Hawking, hawked by Bird. Tripuka inside, sets up Woolridge. That was close to a technical, and Hank Raymonds is saying, hey, wait a minute, why isn't there a technical on that one?
You know what, Dick, he did hook it too, but he only did it with one hand. Oliver Lee grabbed with both hands.
Irish jump into a 6-point lead. We played 2 minutes.
matchup underneath. Oliver Lee's too big for Tracy Jackson and Pope.
Lee back outside. Easy to spot with that zero on his back. Against Woolridge, and he pops it. Young man lucky to be alive in a very serious auto accident last summer. Here's the play by Woolridge.
All right, watch the inside hand. See if hook? Definitely a technical.
Should have gone, and that was not consistent. They had just called the same play at the other end.
Sometimes the officials are out of position to call on.
Whistle away from the ball. Worthen holding Hanslick, I believe.
It was a good call. It was a weak side pick. Notre Dame has a lot of weak side pick, and that means the ball, run a string from one basket to the other. Whatever side of the court the ball's on is called the strong side. The other side is called the weak side. Most great teams do their work on the weak side of the court, away from the ball.
Jackson sets up Woolridge. 10-4. Notre Dame leads. Woolridge has four. Foul situation early is interesting. Marquette with four fouls. Notre Dame none. Is Slunt just back of the game. Wilson is fouled as he goes up. Tripuka got it. First Notre Dame penalty. And it'll be a two-shot opportunity for Michael Wilson.
I was a little surprised at Marquette the way they come out of the gate. Normally when you come to South Bend, the first minute you hold the ball. You try to take the crowd out of the game.
They're calling that not a shooting attempt by Wilson. It appeared he wanted to go up with it.
Notre Dame's in the 2-3 zone because the ball was taken out the baseline.
Worthen with a little traffic control didn't seem to be happy with what was happening along the baseline. Lee, Wilson, Worthen from 20. Nice off touch, popped out. Is it a basket? Yes, it is.
Yeah, Orlando Woolridge put his hand in there when the ball was on the rim. There's a cylinder from the top of the rim going to the ceiling of any gymnasium in the country. Watch it here. Ball gets on the rim. Watch the hand go up and touch it. There it is. That's illegal.
Good camera work, guys. Tripuka off to Woolridge. He's got 6 points in a hurry, half of Notre Dame's total. And we've played 3.5 minutes. Woolridge has been hot. The last 10 games, he has been in double figures every game, playing the best ball of his career here at Notre Dame.
Moving from a forward to a center, which is difficult.
Oliver Lee hits a line drive jumper. It's 12-8. Lee with four. He's the leading scorer for the Warriors, just under 17 a game.
You can't let him shoot. Oliver Lee's a pro ball player. He's only a junior at Marquette, but he can do it all. He's a scorer.
Branning to Jackson. Bird, a good job defensively. Tripuka loses his man. Can't hit. Oliver Lee with a rebound. Loses it, and it goes out of bounds to Notre Dame. Tough break for Marquette. Three men in blue uniforms surrounded it, none could corral the ball.
Well, Lee went up with one arm that time and tried to cuff it down, and I think he gets so high, he got nervous.
Timeout here at the ACC on the Notre Dame campus. We played 4 minutes and 16 seconds, and the Irish lead by four. It's a Notre Dame crowd, but that man in the center of your picture, George Thompson, all-time Marquette scorer.
George B.F. Thompson, Drew Force out of Erasmus High School. He was the one that started this thing at Marquette 15 years ago. He started the dynasty. He was the first person to get people up off their seat in the arena.
That's great. He set his record in 3 years, and no one has broken it yet. 12-8, Notre Dame leading Marquette, a whistle away from the ball, and we have a foul against whom? I believe a Notre Dame Hanslick. Yes, offensive foul.
42. He was muscling Wilson trying to post up on him underneath that time.
12-8, the score of Notre Dame's ball, and it'll be Marquette going the other way.
Hank is quite nervous today. He knows it's quite an important game. He's up off the bench early.
Since replacing Al McGuire as the head coach 3 years ago at Marquette, Raymond's is 61-19. Had a lot of tough luck recruiting this last year. Some outstanding prospects that he thought he had, the last minute change of mind, and he really came up with only one freshman, Schlunt, and a couple of walk-ons.
Well, Terry Schlunt is a pleasant surprise.
Marquette trying to cut the Notre Dame lead to two. We played 4.5 minutes. The Irish in his zone, and a whistle against Toome. It is a technical foul on Hanslick. Hanslick got the foul and a technical.
foul, and Digger Phelps is going to get him out of the game. So the senior loses his composure.
Well, he's a competitor. Hanslick goes at it. He's out and play, makes some mistakes, but he feels by making the mistake, he'll still play a better ball game by going at it 100%.
So the technical will be shot by Oliver Lee, who is hitting nearly 79%, and then Marquette will have the ball out. The foul, of course, was a common foul.
By taking Bill out at that time, it might break Notre Dame's rhythm. They were leading 12-8 when that technical foul came about.
All right, let's just mark that point, 12-8, and we'll see what happens. Coach, Marquette trails by three, and the Warriors have the ball. And Jim Paxon, 23, the freshman from Dayton, Ohio, has replaced Hanslick. Worthen, 6'5 and a half, great size for the way he handles the ball. Protected with those long arms. Look at him maneuver inside for the 12-footer, and it's 12-11.
He's tough. Notre Dame's going to have to go to his own to stop Sam.
4 points for Worthen.
Jerry Lyons at Loyola says that he's the greatest point guard in the business.
This is as close as Marquette has been since the opening tip-off. Cut the lead to one. Tripuka. Branning. Rich Branning. Can't hit it. Rebound to whom? Tracy Jackson.
Mr. Instant Offense, Tracy Jackson. Excellent ball player. They got Robert Furry on, so Coach Raymond thinks that he's the best offensive ball player on Notre Dame. Whoever they put Robert Furry on is the best offensive player.
Jackson forces that one, but Woolridge is there, and the foul is on Woolridge. That's one of those cases where Woolridge really didn't do anything wrong, but got himself caught in a position where there was contact and a whistle had to be blown.
He had no place to land. You're supposed to allow a person when he comes down to land someplace, but just an accident. Watch, here he's up in the air, he just couldn't come down. And he ended up going into Michael Wilson, charge and foul, but not a fair foul. The referees had no choice in that ticket.
They could have called traveling, I guess, is the only other choice. It would have been a fair call.
Well, I don't think a charge and foul should be a foul, it's a personal foul.
Worthen trying to give Marquette the lead, and he forces the shot. Tripuka with a rebound. 6 minutes gone. Branning with a long lead pass. Nice move along the baseline and a block. And a foul is called on Schlett, I believe. He had his hand firmly on the ball, maybe got him with the body.
He might have got him with the body, but to me it looked like he had a good block in the ball, but he might have caught him with his hip. I'm not sure. This is important because Marquette's now on the 15th foul, I believe.
Fifth on Marquette, four for Notre Dame. Two-shot opportunity for Branning, who is moving up on the all-time Notre Dame scoring list. He is currently 13th all-time with 1,200-plus points, and he needs 14 today to pass Dick Rosenthal, the number 12 in Notre Dame history. 13-11, Branning's first point of the game.
Just token pressure here. Nothing to do. Holy secret.
Oliver Lee.
We're in a 1-2-2 zone right now.
Way outside Wilson, and he barely gets the rim. Rebound and a score. Slipping underneath was Lee, and it's a tie game and a foul.
Michael Wilson, again, is not putting enough trajectory on his shot. It's a pancake shot. Here's the shot. Watch how low the trajectory is. There's no room against the basket. See that? Oliver Lee gets the ball, gets the inside step, goes up, plays it off the glass, three-point play.
And Woolridge got the foul, his second. Oliver Lee already with 7 points for the Warriors. He's from DeLand, Florida, and when Marquette played earlier this week down in DeLand against Stetson, lost that game. Of course, he was back home, and a lot of youngsters out there just to watch Marquette practice and cheer their hometown hero. Oliver Lee was just giving Marquette the lead, 14-13.
Stetson blocked trap for Marquette.
The drive by Branning, the follow by Woolridge. Orlando Woolridge gives Notre Dame the lead.
Beautiful, Orlando. That was just a beautiful offensive play.
8 points for Woolridge. So the 2-0s, Orlando and Oliver, Woolridge and Lee leading their respective teams. Woolridge with 8 and Lee with 8.
Orlando looked like Willis Reed that time.
And Willis Reed, of course, is his uncle. Through a Willis Reed basketball camp, Digger Phelps participating in it, that he saw Orlando Woolridge and recruited him. Carol Schlunt, the youngster, just a freshman, has his first bucket, 17-15, Marquette.
He's having a tough time with Kelly Tripuka underneath.
Check that, 16-15 is the score, Marquette. 7 minutes played. Tracy Jackson puts Notre Dame back in front, 17-16. He has five.
Tracy has tremendous body control when he's up in the air for any offensive shot.
He always scores himself up to the basket in midair, doesn't he? Worthen, almost a steal. Lee, loose ball. Rebound, Tripuka. Irish have three men averaging between 6.5 and 7 rebounds a game. Good balance. Woolridge, Tripuka, and Jackson all in that 6.5 to 7. Those are good numbers for Digger Phelps' well-balanced team.
They still have a problem without that big man in the middle. Tim Andre's just a freshman. He might come in a year or two.
Woolridge can't connect. Rebound Wilson. Boy, he gets up there for a little guy. And then Bird took it away from his teammate. Fans wanted it out of bounds to Notre Dame.
What normally happens to Marquette is Robert Bird tires the second half. He doesn't get as many rebounds.
Bird with the ball. Lob pass, and it misses Worthen as Wilson has a tough chance.
That was a good pass.
Timeout here at Notre Dame. 12 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in the first half. The hometown Irish 17, the visitors from Marquette 16. Very, very big basketball day for you fans. We not only have the game that will probably decide the Big Ten championship, Ohio State and Indiana, and some great stars in those teams. I want to remind you that after the game, we will have reports for you on the NCAA pairings for the tournament. They will be announced about at the conclusion of that game, and those of us on NBC will not only give you the teams that have been invited, but the pairings. So be with us on Sunday. That's like election day. I know it was 3 years ago when you won the tournament, you didn't think you'd even get in it.
That's right. The last game against Michigan, they gave me word at halftime, and I told the media, if I come out in a different suit, we got in the NCAA. Fortunate enough, we got in, and then the Camelot, the Shangri-La, we ended up winning it.
NBC, of course, carried that game. We remember that so vividly. Here it is, 17-16 Notre Dame. Paxon off to Branning, the Irish with 11:40 remaining in the first half, trying to win their 21st game of the year. They've lost but four. Marquette, 15-8, need a win. Tripuka connects. Kentucky at LSU, midway in the first half. It's LSU 23, Kentucky 22. That one to decide the SEC championship.
LSU is my wild card pick to win everything.
How many wild cards are you going to expose this year?
Going forward to what part of the country I'm in.
Slunt to Worthen. Marquette with the ball trailing by 3 at the 11-minute mark, first half.
They're sitting in the 2-3 zone.
Inside to lead. Blocked nicely by Woolridge. Worthen off the mark. Bird gets the rebound.
Bird just does his job, gets the rebound, gives it to the man, goes back underneath.
Bird is number 8 in the nation in NCAA shooting percentage. Yeah. Wilson drops it down the hole, 19-18.
He picked the ball up a little bit that time, got it higher. He needed that basket.
That was the first for Wilson.
Bird's doing a good job on Tracy Jackson.
The Buka to Jackson. A lot of inside screening by Notre Dame. Rebound, one-handed by Oliver Lee. Marquette with a chance to regain the lead.
Notre Dame's alternating their defenses. They're in man-to-man now.
Bird wanted to go to Wilson inside. Worthen and a foul over the back Branning. As we pause briefly for station identification, this is the NBC Television Network.
Channel 16 in South Bend, WNBU TV.
Of Notre Dame. The ACC sold out over 11,000 fans. The hometown Irish leading Marquette 19-18. A renewal of a long-standing rivalry. It's been intensely competitive between these two teams. Outside is Oliver Lee, and he connects, and Marquette leads Notre Dame 20-19. 10 points for Lee to lead all scores.
The thing about Lee, some people can score from certain parts of the court. He can score all over. He can post up, he can hook, he can shoot from the outside. He's an unbelievable ball player.
Just under 10 minutes remaining in the first half. The big game for Marquette. They have to impress. The men will make the decision with a victory over a tough team, Notre Dame, on the Irish court. Otherwise, they might be left at home for the NCAA. Branning, not there. Rebound, Jackson. Tripuka, nice move on the baseline and a foul.
No, he stepped out of bounds. Oh,
little bumping there. The right foot on the side. Boy, you coaches see those out of bounds, don't you?
Well, I caught it because I stood up. You were sitting down here yet. And he just put his foot right there. Nice camera work, Mr. C.
Harry Coyle, our director, Kenneth Edmondson, our producer, Oliver Lee, the shooter, and he hits another, a dozen for Lee, and Marquette with a three-point lead. That's their largest of the game.
Digger, you better get someone on him, move up on him.
Now the crowd, the student body section at the right side of the court, on their feet, trying to get the Irish going. Foul is against Robert Bird.
Hairline call, but a good call by Jim Bain, the official.
Reminder later today on Sports World, a fine boxing match live from Las Vegas. Roberto Duran, who is looking for a shot at Sugar Ray Leonard's title, will fight Wellington Wheatley. 10-round scheduled from Vegas, plus Pro Roller Disco Invitational. That's to follow our basketball coverage. 109 minutes remaining in the first half. Marquette 22, Notre Dame 19.
They're setting back a little bit. They're not in the zone. They're just letting the outside men keep the ball outside because Marquette has the lead. You've got to come at them and play.
A whistle away from the ball, and it's on Marquardt, number 45, trying to stop Tripuka's break.
You know that accident that Marquardt had in August? A young lady died in the automobile accident. He had 15 broken ribs. He had a collapsed lung. He had a shattered right arm. So he's really come back. He's a great athlete. Thank God he's alive.
There's a timeout with 8:35 remaining in this first half at Notre Dame, where Marquette leads the Irish by three. $1,000 at stake. The Bay Hill Classic, Arnold Palmer the host. That's next weekend here on NBC. It is 22-19, Marquette leading Notre Dame. A reminder that the Gillette Track 2 people award a $1,000 scholarship to the most valuable player, school, and a fine certificate to that individual. We'll name the winner later in the telecast. Kelly Tripuka at the line for Notre Dame.
Both teams are in a 1-1. Kelly's shot has been kind of heavy. Let's see if he softens it up this time. Usually if you raise your hand a little bit high, it'll soften it up. No, that was heavy again. He was fortunate that dropped in.
22-20 Marquette. Second team All-America last year was Tripuka, and a first team academic All-America.
It's too heavy.
Robert Bird with a rebound.
I'm surprised now. He missed four foul shots. Someone should correct him and just say adjust your arm.
Would you really, as a coach, tell a player during the course of the game, give him a tip like that?
Pick up. Now Wilson started to pick up his shot a little bit higher.
Lee with a left-handed tip. He's doing everything. Oliver Lee with a left hand bats it home. 14 for him.
Surprisingly, Marquette staying with the man-to-man.
Good nice move by Jackson. Oh. And a foul against whom?
Professional move by Tracy Jackson that time.
Foul is on Oliver Lee of Marquette, is first. Both teams are in the bonus. Here comes Bill Varner, a man that Marquette thought was going to come to the Milwaukee campus and changed his mind at the last minute, went to Notre Dame, and he'll come in for Tripuka. Robert Bird leaves the lineup for Marquette, and Schlunt has replaced him. In case you're wondering, he's not related to the former Indiana All-American, Don Schlunt, big center of the 50s for Branch McCracken. Jackson misses, so a little ice at the free throw line for Notre Dame.
This foul shot's unbelievable. They catch it. Branning went one for two.
Jackson makes one, cuts Marquette's lead to three at 24-21. 8 minutes left first half.
Spreading them out now.
Worthen inside to Marquardt. Stolen by Jackson. He leads Notre Dame in steals. Backhanded pass and flipping it out with Schlunt right to Paxon. He can't score, but he was fouled. Looked like Schlunt might have walked with the ball, and that foul's going to go against Paxon, and that brings a roar of disapproval from this Notre Dame crowd.
Here's the pass over here where Tracy Jackson intercepts Marquardt's pass. He gets a little French pastry here, passes behind his back. I thought he should have went all his way. Terry Schlunt gets the ball. It's a turnover that happens now. Now watch the walk right before the shot. There it is. There's a walk right there, and that's a ref's ball one way or the other.
They did charge Paxon with a foul, his first. 7.5 minutes. Worthen with some clever work. Can't get the goal, and a foul on Woolridge. advantage of Notre Dame. So that whistle going against the Irish at this point.
A lot of times at South Bend here, the officials overreact. And for some reason, subconsciously, they don't want the game to get out of hand.
That's three on Woolridge. First man in foul trouble, and Digger Phelps is going to go to the bench. Gil Salinas, 55. 6'11 center from San Antonio, Texas, comes in. Digger with the Levi pants and the pink coat, cowboy boots.
I was speaking to Salinas' parents before the game, and they said, we'd like for you to call him the gentle giant rather than Supermex. They didn't say the ending, but they said they'd rather you call him the gentle giant. He really is a nice young guy.
He is indeed. So is this man, Michael Wilson from Memphis, Tennessee.
Ooh, a crier.
25-21 Marquette. Wilson looking for his fourth point of the game. Jackson comes out, and Tripuka replaces him in the Notre Dame lineup.
Bill Hanslick is back in there now. Notre Dame should start moving.
That's right. You marked that the score at the time he went out was 12-8. And since that time, Marquette's outscored Notre Dame by 8 points. Yeah. 9 points. Biggest lead for the Warriors at five. 7:22 left in the first half.
I believe, personally, the key to Notre Dame is Bill Hanslick.
Inside to Hanslick. 15-footer, 26-23 on Varner's first points. Varner from New Kensington, Pennsylvania, freshman.
Notre Dame's playing tough man-to-man defense.
Worthen gets his own rebound, takes it in. 28-23.
He's quick off his feet.
6 points for Worthen. 6.5 minutes remaining in the first half.
Fighting Irish need a basket right here.
Paxon sets up Tripuka. And he bounces one home. 28-25, Tripuka has six. And that has just moved him against ahead of Gary Novak. He's the number 18 scorer all time. Here's Tripuka. Novak had his 5 moments for the Irish. Worthen sees some daylight up the alley and scores. No, traveling is the call against Worthen.
Okay, but you can't let Worthen get into the middle. When he gets into the middle of your zone, your man-to-man, he just destroys the whole defense.
Timeout has been called here at Notre Dame with 6 minutes and 7 seconds remaining before the intermission. It's 28-25, Marquette. Familiar strains of the fight song here at Notre Dame. It was a nice moment, Coach, before the start of the game when the fans here in the